Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit.
Video bandwidth for the Giz Wiz is provided by CacheFly at CacheFly.com. Audio bandwidth for the Giz Wiz is provided by the new Winamp for Android, featuring wireless sync and one-click iTunes import. Now with free daily music downloads and full-length CD listening parties. Download it free at winamp.com/android.
It's time for the Giz Wiz with Matt's maddest writer, Dick DiBartolo. This is episode 1407, recorded March 12th, 2013. It's made of chamois. The Giz Wiz is brought to you by Man Packs, manly goods on a schedule. Get started today and have underwear, socks, toiletries, shaving supplies, and more delivered to your door. Visit manpacks.com/twit and get $10 off your first order of $30 or more. Or buy a $50 gift card for $40 at Man Packs.
And now, get ready for Dick.
Well, faith in Megara, I've dyed my urine green. It's St. Patrick's Day on the Giz Wiz.
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D and Leo Laporte on Twit TV. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease. Under pathology, rows and rows of USBs, growing blue and LEDs.
Whoa! They blew it up! They blew up the Giz Wiz theme! Run
go,
the thrill
go, go.
Come on, thrill game! Come on!
Come on, Delaire! There we go!
That didn't quite go so well.
It exploded into a box of tissue!
Yeah, that was my fault. You can blame me on that one.
And I see Dick has dyed his mustache green for the occasion. I think that's wonderful.
Yeah.
That's
you
wonderful.
Know what? I need some more conditioner. My stash is out of control.
It's a little curly. I guess when it gets humid, your mustache curls a little bit.
Yeah, it does. It's very humid right now. But it looks very St. Patrick-y, doesn't it?
It's very St. Patrick-y. That's the word. Yes, it is.
St. Patrick-y goes along with my... Poparama.
Yeah, where's your miter?
Yeah.
Dick's not the Pope, but he might have been.
Yeah, yeah. I think I'm up for it, but I'm not sure. Wait a minute.
He's a good Catholic boy.
Absolutely.
Now, do they still paint a green stripe down Fifth Avenue on St. Patrick's Day in New York
City?
Yeah,
I believe that they do. I'm not 100% sure.
I think the
sure.
machine got loose and did something to your face, actually.
I know.
The green stripe's
I'm trying
going.
To get it to stick on my nose so I don't have to hold it, but I can't quite do it.
By the way, if you look closely, you might recognize that as the spritzer.
Oh, boy, you are good.
That comes from, yeah, totally recognize that.
You are amazing.
So that's good. You can use it in the summer to
the
keep 3D. You cool.
It's the 3D.
Whoa.
And I also have my Irish scarf on.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah,
that's good. Good. Are you? Is there anybody in the Disneyland studios with you today?
I know. Myra should be here shortly.
She's, oh, good.
I mean, sneaking out of work as we speak.
I mean, snacks will arrive shortly after that.
Yes, exactly.
Let's try the thrill cam.
I wish you'd get here because I need a drink.
You know, we actually have now two soda streams here in the studio.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
Great.
But we don't use them. I mean, I guess it's for the Pixel Core because we still go to Costco and buy, like, cases of soda. We really ought to save money and use the soda stream. Let's try the thrill cam.
Let's try it. Go,
one more
go,
time.
Go.
Thrill cam. Come here. Come to Papa. Come to Papa. Oh, that hit me.
Whoa.
There, the thrill cam socked me in the jaw.
Man, you know, the thrill cam, it gets a rocking.
If the thrill cam is knocking, don't you be rocking. Wow. Wow.
Wow, it still this hasn't is, settled down.
This is that zip line that we got from... From the Sky Mall, folks.
Yeah.
Yeah. We didn't dare ride it, but the thrill cam seems to be completely happy aboard. Wow. So, Dick, you know, I've tried so many risky things on behalf of you and this show. You know, the human rubber band.
The human slingshot.
Slingshot with the orbit wheels. It seems the zip line. It seems like we've done so. But I've never been hurt, you know, knock on wood. So yesterday I fall off my bicycle.
Sprained
my wrist.
Were you on camera at least?
No. I was just riding around town, sprained my leg, my ankle, my wrist. I've abraded and contused.
Are you serious?
Yeah. So all this time I do all these dangerous things for the Giz Wiz, nothing. Complete safety. We were up on the roof throwing things off the roof. Nothing happened. And then I go for a plain old two-wheel, not even on my trike, two-wheel bicycle ride. Wiped out completely.
Unbelievable.
So if I limp a little bit during the show today, that's what's going on.
Oh, okay.
I was thinking maybe of doing the show seated or in a wheelchair with my leg up, but, you know, I think I'm all right.
Come on, you're in show business.
That's right. The show must go on.
The show must go on.
I do think I've lost about a foot and a half, however. I think I'm shorter than I used to be.
Maybe we're still framed for your really tall hat from last week.
Yeah, maybe that's it. That could be it.
I think, though, the moral of this is wear the sumo suit 24/7. For pure safety.
Absolutely. And you'll lose a lot of weight besides.
Oh, man.
Especially in the warm summer months.
Yeah, but no one will know. That's the beauty of it.
Yeah, that's...
So we do have a SkyMall object dart.
Oh, good.
Yeah,
good.
That we'll give you a little review of in just a little bit.
Good.
But let's start. You kick things off because...
I wanted to mention Thursday, I'm going to... I think it's a private affair. I think it's a one-on-one affair.
All my affairs are private. I just feel more... Actually, that's not always true.
Yeah,
Never mind.
I'm going to see the Galaxy 4.
Oh! Are you going Wednesday?
You know New York well, right?
Yes.
This person said, Dick, meet me at Radio City Music Hall.
Oh, that's easy to find. That's right, just south of Broadway and north of 80th Street.
And I think it's just the two of us. I'm not...
No, there's a big event there on Wednesday. Are you going? Go on Wednesday.
No, it's Thursday night, isn't it?
Well, if you can go on Thursday, but the event's Wednesday.
Okay.
Isn't it? Okay. Am I wrong, Jason?
I think it's Thursday. But is it Thursday?
Yeah. Host of All About Android, he should know. This is the Galaxy S4 announcement. I'm so jealous.
Yeah.
I'm so jealous.
I mean, you know, Radio City Music Hall holds 6,500 people.
Well, so. There'll be a lot of people there. You know, they did an amazing thing. Is it tonight? I think the Galaxy, the Samsung party at South by Southwest, either it was last night or tonight, Prince is performing. First time he's ever performed at South by Southwest. Samsung is spending a lot of money promoting this. Oh. You might see his purpleness at the Radio City Music Hall with the Rockettes.
It could be.
That'd be amazing.
Yeah. Well, you know, for the Note 2, they rented the General Post Office.
What?
Yes. The General Post Office has a huge indoor area for trucks. Which they totally covered with drapes.
They've come a long way.
Wooden floors. It was amazing. I mean, I'm walking down the block. I'm going, what is this? 217 West 34th. How am I going to? And I see the entire post office lit in blue.
Oh, my goodness.
With a big Samsung logo on the building that they're projecting with lasers. And I go, I think I found it. I don't think I need a GPS for this.
Well, I'm very jealous because this is a huge announcement. And they've done a very good job of kind of keeping it under wraps. Right, Jason? We don't really know what the Galaxy S4. We have some ideas. We've seen some maybe pictures.
Yeah, exactly. There have been some leaks, but you don't really know what's for sure at this point.
Well, so we'll cover this. So Thursday, huh?
Mm-hmm. It is Thursday. Yes.
So we'll cover this event. It's right around 4 o'clock our time, 7 o'clock your time, I think.
That is correct.
Yeah,
that is
correct. And maybe we can get the All About Android team in to cover this with me, because this is a big announcement.
I even believe the invite said they'll be streaming it live, so you have
perfect.
No problem.
Perfect. That's what we like, so we can sit there and comment on it.
Exactly.
I'll wear this hat.
Exactly.
Very exciting. Very exciting. You know, I'm really trying to decide what my next phone will be, and it's either that, although that won't be out at least for another month. Mm-hmm. Friday, I think the HTC One comes out on Sprint.
No, and that's looking at delays, possibly.
No,
possibly. It's kind of up in the air right now. So hopefully it'll still come out this week.
Well, if it doesn't, then it might really be a real toss-up between the two.
Yeah.
We'll watch All About Android. Tonight's the 100th episode.
That's right.
Of All About Android.
100 episodes. Got a few cool guests lined up as well. So
Ron will be there. Ron Richards, Jason.
Ron will have the duck in. He's traveling right now. It sounds like we might possibly get Eileen for a short bit.
Oh, that'd be nice.
Of course,
founding member of the show, Eileen Rivera. Gina Trapani.
Kevin Purdy's joining us. Andy Anatko, we're doing an interview with him.
Because
he went Android. Exactly. So
this
it'll
be
a cool episode.
I go Android nothing. No excitement. Nobody says a word. Andy Anatko goes Android. It's like the biggest story ever happened. And it's funny because Andy and I on MacBreak Weekly, we'd get in these, not fights, but I'd say, Andy, you really ought to try Android. It's great. No, the fit and finish isn't there. It's not polished like my iPhone. I said, Andy, but it does somebody great. No, I'll never go in. And now he goes Android. He gets all the attention. I should have held out a little longer, I think.
Yeah, you should have, pal. Yeah, should have.
Yeah. Anyway, you've been using Android for some time. You're an Android user.
I like Android.
Yeah, me too.
I really do. Yeah. I do.
So what do you got? What's our first gadget of the
day? Well, we're going to start with a very bizarre gadget, and it's going to be the Giz Wiz video of the week. Woo-hoo. So you can see it for yourself.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest, try to end the Giz Wiz with another one-take theater here on Twit. Email from a viewer saying, can you please buy the acoustic horns and demo them on the Giz Wiz? Mm. So I bought a pair of acoustic horns. This is what they look like. So the idea here is that they're acoustic horns. You know, acoustics is a way to sort of make a device sound louder by shielding it or putting into something to make it louder without battery power. A few weeks ago on the Giz Wiz, we had an acoustic case for an iPhone. You popped the back up, it came up and made like a horn. So these are what the acoustic horns look like. You can, they pair together so that you can carry them easily. They pop out and become like 2 5- or 6-inch speakers.
Wow.
Now the power for them, well, there
is
none.
This is the bizarre part.
They are built specifically for iPhone or iPod headphones.
So you put them in your ears.
Have that flat
you
surface.
Put the earbuds
so
into
the flat
them.
Surface goes in the back. And let me get that one up and that one up. And now, if you look in there, maybe hard
to
see,
sense.
But
sure.
Surface of the headphone is now the speaker coil. We're going to do the same with this one. And I'm going to turn that one down so it doesn't roll off the table. We're going to pull this up, put that under there, snap that down.
For those
again,
of you listening
you can
on
see
audio,
the silver
we're
right
going to pull that up
there.
And push this down.
Yeah, right. So we have 2 6-inch silicon horns.
Big speakers.
With earbuds
so
in the
some
back.
Music. I'm using my iPod Touch. Going to music. Oh, Giz Wiz country theme.
Oh, that's pretty loud. Holy cow.
That's without the
that's
horns.
Without.
Oh.
Now.
They really
so
work.
Dennis, you might have to back up. Okay, let's go down to the speakers and hang on, folks.
They're quieter. It's quieter.
Okay. Well,
it's worse.
I just don't
but the
understand
volume is
it.
Really low.
They should be louder.
Oh, they're headphones.
Quieter.
They sound good like this. This would be
he's
a great
them on
way
his
to
head.
Wear them, actually. Okay.
Wear them over
so
your ears.
Mine could be a knockoff, okay? On Amazon, they sell them as Tembo trunks. And they're $40 for a pair.
Oh, outrageous.
And it was a Kickstarter project. Two guys, very sincere about the project. They raised
$88,321. They live in Mexico
now. The problem is, there's only 2 reviews on Amazon, 2 single reviews. Each person gave it 1 star and simply said they just don't work. So that's as much volume as I could get out of them. And yes, my iTouch volume was all the way up. So to me, they don't work. I don't know what you could do with them. Wait a minute. I do know what you could do with them. Hi, boys and girls. Yes, guess what?
He looks like Mickey.
I'm Marty Mouse. I'm Marty
Wear
Mouse.
Wear them over
at
your
Disneyland.
Ears.
Disneyland. Mm. Yeah, I don't know the guy named Mickey at the other land. But anyway, Marty Mouse saying hi to all the fans of the Giz Wiz and have a very good mousy day.
Sticky Mouse.
Whatever that means.
D-I-C. See you real soon.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah. So it just is bizarre.
Well, it's not bizarre.
It's not
bizarre.
Seems like
it's exactly what you would expect.
Like,
if they'd asked me, I would have told them the speakers on the iPod Touch or the iPhone are designed to go loud. That's why the cases that add little horns to those speakers work. But the iPod headphones are not very loud.
No, they're not.
Because they're right in your ears. They don't need to be. It's not enough just putting a cone around them. Is it going to make any difference?
I know. It is one of the stranger gadgets.
I am so sick of Kickstarter.
It doesn't really look much different from the headphones that you're wearing right now.
No, actually.
You're absolutely right. Maybe I should just wear those.
Yeah, exactly.
Very important bottom line on this. People and Kickstarter themselves say that we're not a store. You're not coming here to put your money down on a hot new product. This is all speculative. When you get something on Kickstarter, it may not work. I can't tell you how many junky things now I've gotten from Kickstarter, from that ostrich pillow.
Oh,
right?
The ostrich pillow. That was strange.
I ordered something called a Nifty Drive. Boy, was that a mistake. I got my Nifty Drive the other day. I'm starting to get Kickstarter projects that I've got. The Nifty Mini Drive, the idea was it adds to the capacity of your hard drive on your Macintosh, MacBook Retina, or your MacBook Air, because they have an SD card slot. So the idea is it's an SD card you put in there, but it's flush mounted, right? They raised $384,000, some of it mine, for this thing. In fact, here, can you see the video?
I'm not getting your video.
Yeah.
I just pulled
this
up.
So I got my Nifty Drive the other day. I stuck it in. I got it for the right one. Not only did it not mount, did I not see an additional storage. When I then tried to pull it out with at least they included a hook, the thing you hook it on pulled right off, and the drive stuck in the computer. It had the devil of a time prying it out. So, getting stuff from Kickstarter, you're participating in an experiment. This is not stuff these guys have tried. Because I gave them extra money, I gave them they sent me the Nifty tool, which is just a piece of bent wire. That's the Nifty tool.
Turned out you needed it, though, right?
Yeah, thank goodness.
Yeah.
Anyway, I have... Now, others say, oh, no, we've got great stuff from Kickstarter, but I have to say most of the stuff... You know, the Joey bra, the ostrich pillow. Maybe it's me. Maybe I'm picking poorly. The Nifty Drive. I still am waiting
But you looked great in the Joey bra. Let's not.
Oh, no.
Let's not.
It was flattering. It was flattering.
Flattering. Yeah. But I could not hear any sound coming out of it, no matter how carefully I listened.
Oh, no. No sound came out. And so these things, they raised the money. They got the money. But it wasn't enough to make a product that worked.
Okay.
There you go.
So now, for the same price, under $40, the horns were $39.95. So now, for under $38 on Amazon, let's take a look at the Matrix Audio Cube.
Oh,
now this is a tiny, tiny speaker, and
I have one of those.
You do have one of those?
I do. They sent me some.
Oh, okay, great. So it's a little audio speaker. You charge it with USB. It comes with a cable that can charge via USB, and also the same cable uses it for your headphone. Have you played yours? Because I think for its size, I'm going to take it off my table there and hook it up. Have you played with yours, Leo?
No, I haven't. It's on my desk there.
Okay. Okay,
how does it sound? Because I haven't tried it yet.
Okay, I'm going to...
Now, there's a couple of different ones. There's one that you charge up with a USB connector.
That's this one.
And then they have Bluetooth ones that just are Bluetooth.
Right. Well, this one on Amazon is $38. So let's just...
Now, that sounds good.
So that's the iTouch by
that's
itself.
Touch again. Okay.
Okay. And now let's... Do it with this. Hello, play. Did I knock this off? Oh, I knocked the switch to the off position. And are you going to tell me that this battery went dead suddenly?
Oh, no. nuts.
Yeah, it's blinking, blinking blue, like dead. Oh, I cannot believe it.
Well, that's one
anyway,
negative.
You know what? I'll charge it up and I'll play it at the end of the show.
All right.
Okay.
So, did you hear it? What did it sound like?
Oh, it sounds really good. The fun thing is to plug it in, play it, and let people come in like up at Mad, be playing something and say, how's this sound? They go, oh, that sounds pretty decent. And then you pick up this little guy and go, you know what? That's from this tiny little Matrix Audio Cube. So the sound for its size is amazing. Its list price is $50, but as I said on Amazon, it's now, I think it's $38. Oh, there it is, $37.19.
Now, they also make this. This is, did they send you one of these? This is their Bluetooth speaker that has a microphone as well, so it's wireless. I'm just pairing it right now with my phone.
Okay, good. Well, you do that. I'm just going to plug this in and charge this up.
Okay. So as soon as this is paired, which I haven't done yet, but I did charge it up. And by the way, I charged it up a long time ago. So let me just play some music out of this one, because this is not the same. Yours is like solid metal and fairly heavy.
Mine's
this
like an aluminum box.
Yeah, right. This is more like... pop it like it's hot. See, now this is pretty good. I think that's not bad. But I mean, what I should do is make a phone call with this, because it also is a Bluetooth microphone. You know, it's a headset as well. Not super high quality audio, but for a phone call, this would be fine. It's not really great for Snoop Dogg. I don't, you know. But I'm sure yours sounds better because it's metal and it's...
Well, I'm just trying to get a plug that can reach as far as my...
Well, that sounds good. What's that? Wait a minute, is that you? That's not... That's very good. That actually sounds full fidelity. How loud is that?
That's pretty good, isn't it?
Yeah, it sounds remarkably good.
It suddenly dawned on me, since it's the same cable that has USB as the headphone, I figured I'll just power it directly from the computer and plug it into the iPod Touch.
Well, and that's another way you can use it, by the way, is you can use it as a computer speaker and you don't have to use the battery at all. It's just always hooked up to it.
Exactly. And it's, you know, really small enough to... was yours... show yours again, Leo. Is it about this?
It's a little bigger than the metal cube.
Right. Okay.
And it's plastic. You know, so it's almost like, I wonder if it predated it's the same company. And this one is different because it has Bluetooth. You do charge it with a mini USB connector there, and it has a volume. You press this button to pick up the phone.
Oh, okay.
You can click it to play or rewind. So you have music control here, and then it's either blind line or Bluetooth. So I'm keep playing rap music. Let me get to the library. I could play something. Here we go. Here's Destiny's Child. Everybody loves Oh, let's see. Let's download this here. Yeah. So it has for the line, I guess it has a line jack? I don't see a line jack. I only see USB. Anyway, these are pretty cool. And that yours sounds really good. Play it on the Twit TV.
Yeah, I'll come back now.
Oh, look at this. Look at this. Somebody in the chat room says, Leo, does it twist open? Some of these speakers twist open for better bass.
Oh, it's one of those that adds bass.
It's got a little twist. Now let me play it. Now let's see how it sounds. You're right, it did help the bass. It's not very loud, but the bass is pretty good.
At first we thought it out real cool.
It's not bad.
It's not super loud. It's, I think, more designed for speakerphone kind of applications.
Yeah.
But that's
yeah.
Matrix also. So Matrix makes these, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Mine is the Matrix Audio Cube, and I forgot what yours is called.
I don't know either. It's probably something with Bluetooth in the name.
Okay.
Anyway, cool. That's Gadget 2, and I happen to have one as well.
Okay, good. So, yeah, charge it for 2 hours, and we'll play for 8 hours. Now, Gadget 3 is another video. It's a kind of a bizarre video, preceded by an even more bizarre letter. So we asked people to send us videos. I invented this, my favorite gadget ever. I bought a piece of crap, my gadget warehouse. So this is our second, I believe our second, I invented this. I believe our first one was a guy who took a truck and converted it to run on gas, I think.
Yeah, that was quite a while back.
Yes, exactly. It might have been one of, it was probably our first I invented this. So this is, let me read the intro to this. Hey, Dick and Leo, this is my I invented this video. This huge wheel was a feature of a failed TV show pilot I made in Australia called Maynard's Wheel of Whoopsie. I know. It was the Tonight Show meets the Soup. This was back in 1995. Contestants were strapped to the wheel, spun around to win prizes, and they couldn't get off it until they got a question correct or worse. I'm not quite sure what that means. Thinking back, I have no idea why this show was not picked up. The Wheel of Whoopsie was solidly built on wheels to move it around the stage or the studio. The Wheel of Whoopsie. The spindle for the wheel was made from a Chrysler axle. Kept it in my garage for several years after the pilot. I used it as a casual talking point, like, yes, I heard Madonna's new album, but have you seen the wheel in my garage? Eventually, lacking a gadget warehouse and moving several times, I asked if anybody would like it. A mistress in King's Cross, Sydney, sent two minions to pick it up, and I believe Maynard's Wheel of Whoopsie now enjoys its autumn years as the Spanish wheel somewhere underground, not far from the famous Coke sign in King's Cross. I don't need to write any more. I'm sure you guys are having fun with this letter already. Maynard, Sydney, Australia. P.S. I interviewed Leo shortly after he started the Twit Cottage in 2008. I'm sure he doesn't remember it because no wheel was involved. So now, Maynard's video of the week, I invented this.
Roll up, roll up, roll up, folks. Come and see death-defying acts of stupidity. Complete and utter acts of idiocy. Yes, that's right, folks. Don't try this at home. In fact, you can't try this at home unless you have Maynard's wheel.
Wow. It looks dangerous. Oh my God, he's on it!
Oh, why not?
Yes, and the object is to have to do chores on while you're on.
Like, before you throw up?
Like play bongos.
Oh my goodness. I'm not surprised they didn't air this show. It sounds like trouble.
Leo, we could get it when we do a game show.
Would he ship it to us?
Oh, probably.
Maynard, bring your wheel
Lord
next time.
Almighty, I feel my temperature rising. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
I have a headache just looking at that.
It's just bizarre. It's just bizarre. But it just shows you we'll even take bizarre here. So if you have a video of the week, I invented this, my favorite gadget of all time, my gadget warehouse item that you hate to throw out. Put it on eBay and send an email to Jason.
Put it on YouTube. Put it on YouTube before you put it on eBay.
The wheel is going. I'm sorry. The wheel should be on eBay.
Yes.
The video should be on YouTube, and send a link to Jason at gizwiz@twit.tv.
Wow. Bap, bap,
bap. Yeah, I like the blinking.
Wow. Though. Isn't that? I think we should have one in here. We could throw knives.
Yeah.
Oh, great.
Don't you?
Yeah.
As long as I'm not on it.
Yeah. You know, when it comes down to having to cut the payroll by one person,
somebody's going to win. Somebody's going to lose.
You get off the wheel alive, you're on the payroll. If not, and that way there's nothing personal involved in getting rid of someone.
It's completely impersonal.
Exactly.
Dick, do you know what time it is now?
It is time for
my man pack.
Oh, I got a man pack.
You got a man pack? What's in your man pack?
They sent me, it just came yesterday.
So man packs is manly stuff by mail. If you go to manpacks.com/twit, you could save $10 on any purchase over $30 or more, or save, get a $50 gift card for $40. I get my briefs, my underwear there. I get shaving supplies, socks. I'm a big fan of the man pack. What did you get in your man pack?
Everything that you said. I got a pair of Calvin Klein.
Oh, you got the Calvin Kleins. They knew. Yeah. See, they knew that you were a snappy dresser.
The black shorts. I got an American Apparel sports t-shirt.
Oh, very nice. Did you choose these?
Lisa said, what sort of stuff do you wear? And I said, I like dark t-shirts and black underwear.
There you go. All right.
Yeah. And I wonder, I haven't tried this yet. The shave oil.
Oh, you're going to like that. Beard Buster.
And so, Leo, does this replace foam when you shave?
Well, I use both. In fact, I used it today. So here's the deal with the Beard Buster shave oil.
Yes, that's what this is, Beard Buster. Go ahead.
That comes from the Grooming Lounge, a D.C. barbershop where they perfected this stuff. So what I do, you can just shave with the oil. It's got a nice clovey kind of smell to it. It softens the beard. But what really is nice, and I don't know if you got a tube of the shave cream as well.
But no, I didn't, but I got...
How did we?
I got.
That's it. Oh, that's the aftershave.
The aftershave.
Yeah. Well, they have a whole series. So you use the. So what you do is there's the Beard Buster oil. Then you put the cream on there. Then you shave, and it's smooth. Look how clean, smooth. Like just. Oh, come here and feel that. There I as just touched. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just joking.
Feel my ass.
There we go.
Really smooth. Anyway, and then you put the aftershave, the balm on there, and that soothes the skin. No, I love the Grooming Lounge. They even make, and this is what I'd recommend for travelers, a sample kit with all of their products. It's 4 or 5
this
bottles.
This is, Leo, this is what I got for travel. So I bet, it's already in there, the stuff you're mentioning.
Yeah. That's just a sampler that they sent along. Right. But they actually have a little nice plastic bag. It's a good gift product, but also good for travelers. Everything's under, the TSA maximum, and very nice.
Oh, good. Oh, yeah. Perfect. Yeah. Perfect.
So that is, that's Man Packs. You can get $10 off this Twit exclusive, manpacks.com/twit. I actually discovered this because Jeff Jarvis told me about it, and I've been a customer for a couple of years. And I just love it because every 3 months I get another man pack. It's automatic. And you can always change it and shop. They have all sorts of stuff. They even have, I think this is named after you. Sir Richard's condoms. Is that do you make those?
Oh, I just authorized them. I don't actually make them.
Manly goods on a schedule. Go there now. Create your man pack and save money from Manpacks. Manpacks.com/twit. All right, now I know what you were thinking. You were thinking it's time to spin the wheel.
Yes, right.
Spin the wheel on the stuff I buy at Sky Mall. Let's play the jingle. Last week, we asked, this is how it works on the crap I buy from Sky Mall. I ask the chat room for some suggestions before the show. They give us some. Then we put my favorite 3 or 4 on a poll at strawpoll.me. Our last poll was strawpoll.me/8541. What should Leo waste his hard-earned money on next at Sky Mall? The solar-powered cat toy, the beer pager, or the Star Trek, now I wrote caption dress, it's actually captain dress, and I hope that didn't throw you for Liz or whoever fits it. And then look at that, Liz, you're getting a brand new dress. It's the Star Trek caption dress. We'll write a caption on it. 72% of all votes, beer pager, a weak 21%, the cat toy, only 7%. Liz, I can't wait to see you in that Star Trek cap. Let me just show you what this is going to look like on Liz. No, I have an elaborate fantasy life.
Imagination.
Yeah. Star Trek. This is, it's very, very attractive. You'll look like, what you'll look like is Lieutenant Uhuru. Yeah. Yeah, let me see if I can find it here on Sky. Oh, you can't see my screen anyway.
I can. I have it
now.
Oh,
you can now? Yes. Okay, good. Let me just, I wrote Star Trek, Captain's Trek, but it's actually the captain's. I must have been drunk last week. So there it is. Now, this is not a cheap item. This is a $350 dress, Liz.
Whoa.
I hope you'll wear it in good health. We were going to get two, one for me and one for you. But that's an awful lot of money to spend on a one.
Well, you know, it looks like chamois. What does that mean, Adam?
Oh, we'll find out. Chamois. Wouldn't that be nice? I don't know. For $350, I hope it's made out of gold.
Because she could just roll all over your car and polish it.
Doesn't that look good? Isn't that going to be great on her? Can't wait. Can't wait. So she's all excited. You get to keep that, Liz.
Yes.
That's for you.
Halloween.
Yeah, exactly.
Done. Little gift. By the way, we're thinking of hiring Liz's father as our HR manager. I don't know how that's going to work out. just a joke. But doesn't your father do HR?
Yeah.
He does. Yeah, I thought so. I'm in deep trouble. So it's time to choose our next crap from Sky Mall, and we're going to be very topical on this one. Here's your choices. You ready? The Vatican Lions sculpture. These are the same exact lions that you'll find at St. Peter's Basilica in Rome. Ever since the 18th century, these supremely strong and confident beasts have flanked the tomb of Pope Clement XIII in Rome. Created by Canova, the most influential neoclassical sculptor, these awe-inspiring creatures continue the century-old tradition of street sentinels. Cast in designer resin, also known as plastic, these historic lions will guard your bookcase or mantletop. I'm thinking for my tomb. $29.95 for one. Don't get all excited about having two. If you vote for this, we're only getting one. Then next, the Commando dash cam from Kim Commando, my arch rival. You've perhaps seen the dash cam videos from the Russian drivers, you know, of various things. Well, now you can have the same kind of video of the asteroid landing or the alien invasion on your car. Mounts right there, right where you're more likely to get in a crash because you can't see a thing from the dash cam. It's got everything you need, including all these wires. and a 4 GB flash memory card. You can record high-definition video to help you see and hear, protect against fraudulent claims. So the next time I ride a bike, I'm going to have the Commando dash cam. It's actually only $119. Very affordable. I don't know why, but my speakers started making music at that point. By the way, that's so strange. It just started playing. Oh, that stopped it. Okay.
You just scared her. Now she's singing.
It's the strangest thing. I don't know why it would just start playing like that. That's from the fine movie, Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? All right, next. The men's disposable boxer briefs. This is for St. Patrick's Day. I'll dye them green. Actually, maybe they have green. Let's see. Select a color. White or white. Select a size, and I guess I'll be wearing XL. Perfect for sweltering climates, these lightweight disposable boxer briefs are made of soft, breathable, 100% cotton. They're so durable, you could wash and wear them a few times, and they pack in the fraction of a space. You know, you're always throwing out your underwear. Now you can do it legally with these men's disposable boxer briefs.
Yeah, and they're good to draw on because they're nice white.
You could buy briefs for less than $10.85 and just throw them away. I don't know why you'd pay more to throw them away.
No, absolutely. It's just kind of silly.
Let's go to... Where's my straw poll?
You're better off with the Smith & Johnson briefs that come in a little puck and you throw them in water and they expand.
Those would be good. I don't think these are like that.
They're $3.
You wrote down the number, I hope.
Yes, I have it.
All right. What is the straw poll vote number?
Here, you just had it up on your screen. It was 8896.
88. So it's strawpoll.me/8896. There they are. Let's start the votes and play the jingle.
Vote now, it's a snap. Better than a box of crap.
So far, the dash cam is winning, but we'll keep the vote going all week long. Strawpoll.me/8896. The Lions really aren't pulling.
I was just going to say, we do not have a very religious audience.
I guess they don't. They're not worried about guardians for my tomb, apparently.
No, obviously not.
Yeah.
So how do we test the dash cam? Because obviously the great thing about dash cam is you get to catch a lot of crazy things like this. Check this one out.
This is another Russian. Oh!
And the guy comes out and just walks away. Hello.
Wow.
What, did he go
through
the windshield?
Yes.
Yeah, he just hopped right out.
No big deal.
You know, the Russian truck drivers are ready to crash at any time.
Isn't that crazy?
They got one foot out the window at all times, just ready for something to happen. Wow. Yeah, so I guess I'll have to get in an accident.
Or something. You're just going to have to drive around with it for a really long time, catch something crazy.
As soon as I get it, if you vote for it, as soon as I get it, I'll put it in my car, and we won't review it till I've died. And then I'll have the Vatican
okay,
Lions.
All
right, so
one.
This is the Sky Mall crap that we voted on a few weeks ago. This is the life form. It is actually, it's kind of interesting. It fits pretty much anything, and it kind of does look like an alien life form. It's a mounting device for tablet computers, smartphones, cameras, changes shape, grabs onto nearly anything, they say, and allows you to be hands-free almost anywhere, iPhone and iPad not included. So let's just open this up. I do have an iPhone and an iPad here, so we can test it with at least two devices. Let's see what comes in the packaging. Well, that's it. Okay, so there's no. I was thinking there might be something to clamp onto the dashboard, but there really isn't. It's a. And then these arms open up. Like that.
It looks like a giant crab.
Yeah, it kind of does. It seems like there's something missing, but I guess unfold the hinge on the female clamp B. Is that this? Oh, I see. Yeah, there's a female clamp. Unfold the hinge. So this is some sort of strange. Wow. There's a hinge I see there, but I don't know. Maybe because it's screwed in. Oh, yeah. So this is, that's hinged.
Right, okay.
Yeah. Lower the male clamp A, through the space provided on the unfolded female clamp B. Insert the thumb screw C into the space provided underneath the main base E and thread into bolt male clamp A. Do not tighten completely.
Otherwise, you are F.
I have no idea what is supposed to happen here. And then there's this.
Make sure the two pieces do not separate.
I don't understand. For security, life form can be tethered to objects using the holes near the ends of the legs. So you could, it has little holes and little claws here. I don't think this is very practical. I'm not really sure how it's supposed to even work. Maybe a picture on the front. Oh, well, let us know. I see. So these legs are not the clamps. I thought they were the clamps. This is the clamp, and you put your phone in here, like this, and then
you can carry your phone on your shoulder. This is very bizarre.
This is a very strange product. I'm not really sure. Like that, maybe.
That's going to hurt when you put that in your pocket.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I not, you know. I get it. Okay. So now I tighten this down. I'm seeing this here. All right, so that's the clamp. And then this goes here. And I'll tell you, it's a little cumbersome to get the product in, the iPhone or the iPad into this thing. But I think I have it now. And I'm tightening down the thumb screw that they mentioned. And see, now this is fairly tightly held in here. And I think of the female hinge. No, it doesn't do diddly. But there it is. And then And then this.
So now you can, like, hang it over a door?
Yeah, I mean, because this is such a strange object that's completely positionable, you could put it on, like, on here. Or I guess if you were, like, a fan of the movie Alien, you could just clamp it like this.
See, now that looks good.
To your face.
This is
practical.
And then you'd never really need to take your iPhone off.
No. Leo, this is like you can walk and video and not no one would even know.
This is the new Google Glass. You know, of course. What was I thinking? So you could do it like this. It would help if you had little grommets in your head, but
head cam is nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't stick it in your straight eye. Out of Careful. Alien. It looks like H.R. Geiger designed this thing. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, the convenient hooks fit right in your ear. So that's
good.
That makes it easier.
Yeah, this is a good look for you, Leo.
Yeah. And then I just wish I had Oh, wait a minute. They go right in your jowls there too.
Okay, good.
You put the phone screw in there.
Oh, it's like a gag ball.
Okay. Oh, it's nice.
It's good. Yeah. You can walk around. Hello. I'm wearing Google Glass. Don't lie to me. I'm shooting everything.
Google Crab, I think it's called.
Yeah. What do you think? I could put the hat
on. And how much was that?
I don't know. How much was that, Jason?
I have no idea. I can't remember.
There we go. Hannibal Lecter, nice to meet you. Anyway, that's the
life form.
I kick it off.
No.
I just thought.
You should run out on the street with that. Say, they've landed! They've landed!
Oh my
Get
goodness.
It off me! Get
oh my
it
goodness.
Off me!
I'm not easily scared. But
this was $70.
$70.
Oh my word.
$70 for this thing. I don't know. Liz, do you want this? Sure, she'll take anything. I don't know. I think you could do something with it. See that? Yeah. See, that fits in there. Like, there you go.
Oh,
see, that fits in. That's not going to come loose. And then I don't. Yeah. I mean, it's flexible. It's interesting looking.
Can't you hang it on the thing?
Hang it on here?
Yeah, with the
hooks. Oh, maybe it's our new thrill cam.
Oh.
Yeah, because it does. The legs have hooks. So the idea is it is flexible, right? There's things you can do with it that you couldn't do with any other iPhone case or holder. It looks like a dead spider. It's good. Should we slide it?
Oh, it does.
Yeah. Can it slide? Yeah. That's her phone, not mine, thank God. Are you sure you want to do that? Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, honey, don't do that. You'll break your phone. Yeah. Okay. This is definitely not recommended. The life form, you've maybe seen this advertised in other places. It is a strange device. I think we'll find a use for it. You'll probably see it popping up here and there in the Twit Brick House. But I can't really, at $70...
I mean, you can mount it to your bike. That's one thing they show, right? Obvious use for
it. It doesn't feel that secure, to be honest with you.
Okay.
Yeah, and I don't think you really want to bring it to the gym. Oh, that's cute.
Oh, yeah. I don't know that many people that I could get a picture like that.
Now, it looks like the mounting bolt does have the standard thread that you could use in a camera. I would guess that that's why they've got a camera on that, but... maybe rubber grips for comfort and stability, multi-positioning legs, adjustable clamping system, hooked ends. It's interesting. Can't recommend it. It's from lethalprotection.com. So that's our Sky Mall gadget of the day. And Liz has really taken to it. She's taken quite a shine to it. Yeah, there, that's good.
Wow.
Okay.
That'll look good when she has the dress on.
She'll look great in the Who dress with the life form on her head.
Yes.
That is a don't buy. And that's our SkyMall crap of the day. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I think there's but one thing to do to refresh ourselves, a little amuse-bouche, a little something in between courses to freshen the mouth, and that would be a trip down memory lane, a trip to a place we like to call Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy, together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away,
aha!
He takes them out to play.
Ho, ho.
In Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
What do you got in the Gadget Warehouse, Dickie D?
Oh, I have something that is pretty nifty. Actually, it is so nifty that I keep it in my stereo cabinet. Haven't used it in years, but every time I go to unplug it and take it to the warehouse, I go, nah, one day I may want to play vinyl records
of
again.
Of course, yes.
And this was a really, it goes back to about 1980. It's the Philips AF877 turntable. So this was a DC speed-controlled belt drive turntable.
Wow.
LED pitch control.
Oh, that's nice.
Had a little gauge on it to tell you the weight of the cartridge. So it was an integrated stylus force gadget. Had, I think the base was wood, a beautiful cabinet, anti-skating control, which is good because I never skated, so it must have worked. And all the controls are touch sensitive, so you just put your finger on it, the on-off, reject.
Oh, it's like Liz.
Yes, exactly.
Oh,
exactly.
Almost always just reject, but...
Yes, exactly. I was just going to say, that's a slap in the face control. Yeah. You just touch it once and you get such a slap in the face.
She's got a slap in the face touch control. It's true.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So it's really a very handsome turntable, and it was $400 or $500.
Now, are you saying you have this in Disneyland right now?
I have it right now in my apartment sitting on a shelf.
Do you have any records?
I do have all my old 12-inch disco records.
Oh, wow. Of course, it played those just fine.
Yeah, because I used to do my own mixing. I had a mixer and
wow.
I had two turntables and the headphones and the thing. And yeah, no, I did all that. I did all that. But it's, they're all over eBay, everywhere from $250 down to about $18. So not in working condition on the $18 one, but it's the Philips AF877 direct drive turntable.
Well, there are a lot of vinyl aficionados still. The issue, I guess, for me would be, can you get styluses, cartridges for that anymore?
You know, I don't know. This one has, I think, the Grotto. I forgot what cartridge is in mine. And also, you know what? Yeah, I don't see many stories anymore about vinyl coming back.
No.
Last year, remember?
Yeah.
It was a big thing.
No.
I think didn't Abby start buying vinyl records?
Abby, I bought her a USB turntable, the new mark, I think. And she had a little, 10 record collection, Beatles records and stuff. And I think that for her, it was just kind of nostalgic, kind of silly fun. But there are people who take it very serious. Audiophiles say, oh, no, it sounds better. And they have. But, somebody the other day said, well, I heard vinyl is coming back. I said, no, it's not.
No.
I thought
Digivina was going to be catalyst to bring it back.
8-tracks are not coming back. Cassettes are not coming back. Reel-to-reel tape's not coming back. Vinyl's not coming back. Player piano rolls are not coming back. It's gone. It's over. Forget it.
Wow. That pretty much is everything I have in the warehouse.
Your whole collection. Well, that's why it's there. So
that's why
it's there.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
You're waiting for some sort of, I don't know, time travel thing to happen, and these would be valuable again or
yes,
something?
Yes, exactly, exactly. I want to go back in time, sell them, and then come back to today. Is that so hard?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, it's too bad. CDs aren't even coming back. DVDs are on their way out. This is the end of the line is here for those things, I think. And I've never seen technology move backwards like that. But it's fun to see them.
Oh, absolutely.
You got to figure there's a whole generation of people who don't even know what a record is.
No, you're absolutely right.
Right?
Half of them are in your studio.
Right here. All the old farts. I remember bringing Henry over to he called it the music store. I said, yeah, I want to buy a record. He said, what's a record, Dad?
That
I said, it's like a
right.
CD, only it's bigger. It's
That's
He had
right.
no idea. No idea. Somebody in the chat room saying, oh, no, vinyl's coming back. Groups are actually putting their music out on vinyl records even as we speak. It's true.
Really?
It's true. No, that is true. Mm-hmm. I don't think they're selling a lot of them, but there are some people.
They're putting it, yeah.
Yep, yep. Well, let's get a letter. What do you say? You know, we haven't played that Michael Jackson letter theme ever since you found it. Maybe we could find that again.
Oh, wow.
And now a letter from a viewer.
A letter from Carl in Phoenix, Arizona. Love the show as always. You guys are great. Make me laugh each week. I love viewing the show in HD on my HD TV using my Apple TV.
Wow.
Here's a gadget you should feature on the Giz Wiz. I think it looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
And it's called Side Socket. And they're at sidesocket.com. And I think Jason's going to show us a picture of Side Socket. So this is a gadget that the plugs go in the side of it so that, in theory, you can push your furniture all the way back against this device. Now, I did go to the website. It's $10, get one free. So here's the deal. It's buy one for $10, get one free. Just pay separate shipping and handling. So each unit is $8 shipping and handling. So it's $16 and then $10 for the unit. So you end up $26.
Oh, that's not so cheap. Yeah.
No. But when you go, if you go to Amazon.com, just look for the one that is made by a tap light.
Triplight. So the Triplight's a good company.
Triplight.
Yeah, they call it their swivel surge protector.
Yes. But Leo, this one adds surge protection.
Yeah.
And it's just 21 cents more than the side socket. I didn't even know about this gadget. So, Carl, thanks for pointing that out. But I think a better deal is the one from Triplight on Amazon.
Wow, and do you get Amazon Prime shipping on that Triplight?
You know what, I think that one was Prime shipping.
So then it's then.
Can
it
you
really
go back
is,
to that, Jason, for 1 second?
It's half the cost.
I'm sorry, I missed that. What was that?
What's it called? The Triplight. I'm looking at it now. The Triplight.
Oh yeah,
Triplight.
I got you.
Yeah.
Triplight.
It actually there comes out to Swivel. Be the same cost because one of their unit one
oh, it's
side
bucks.
Socket.
Right.
Yeah, $13.
Yeah, it is Prime, Amazon Prime, but you get a surge protector.
Yeah, you get a surge protector. I like it in black, and I also like Triplight because we know that they make good stuff. And under the Globe label, the reviews were not so good. So
I wonder. I hope that somebody didn't steal this idea from somebody else. You know,
what
I'm
that goes on all the time. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah. Actually, you spend $20 for the Triplight home theater version, and it has a RJ11 and coax as well. So that'd be a good thing for behind your home theater. Actually, I have exactly that problem.
Oh.
That's great.
Well, yeah, with plugs sticking out?
Yeah, because my home, the furniture that the TV's sitting on is pushed back against the wall. And the plug's right behind it. So that'd be perfect for that. Yeah. Really good.
There you go. Well, then,
thank you.
And Phoenix, thank you. And thanks for the kind words about the Giz Wiz and Leo and I.
He said nice things about us?
Yeah, he did. He remembered that part about watching us on his HD TV.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Well, he didn't say he liked it. He just said he did watch it.
Oh, no. You guys are great.
Oh, you guys are great. I'm putting that in my collector's book. That's awesome. Dick, you are great. Thank you for doing this. We do the Giz Wiz every Tuesday, 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern time. That's 2100 UTC on twit.tv. Note the time change because of daylight savings time, summertime in the U.S. But you can also watch after the fact or listen. And I know many of you listen. Audio or video available on demand after the fact, twit.tv/GizWiz, or go wherever podcasts are offered, and you can subscribe there and get every episode.
Yes. And also, if they are listening, they should go to gizwiz.biz and at least see a picture of every gadget so they have a better idea what we're talking about.
And play the What the Heck Is It contest.
Oh, yes.
Let's not forget that. Gizwiz.biz. Click that What the Heck Is It link. There it is. That is the... I don't know. That might be a magnetic... I think it's a maglev train track.
Ooh,
for a very,
small
train. It hangs on a hook. I swear it still looks like a towel.
It's the one to Petaluma.
Yeah, that's it. Go vote. Cast your ballot. We got 12 Mad Magazines for the right answer, 24 for the best wrong answer at gizwiz.biz. Hey, Dickie D, thank you. Lots of fun. I'll see you next week. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
The same to you, pal, and I'll be here with my shillelagh.
Oh! Whoa! Here it comes!
The throw cam!
I wasn't looking. It went right behind me.
Oh, no! Hit the gas line.
I wonder if I could just send it up by throwing it? That doesn't go very far. Oh, let's get the other view. Here it goes. Let me throw it. Ready? And one, two, three, throw! Bye-bye!